Check everything's going live here. Hang on. Let's go. Off we go.
Ready to roll?
Ready to roll.
Sorry, everybody. Took a little bit of time today.
Yeah, sorry. I had a little outside lighting problem. Plus, I got bit by a spider. Holy mackerel, right in the middle of my forehead. So now I have three eyeballs. This bad boy is starting to evolve. But anyway.
Happy Monday, everybody. Monday, July 13th.
Right, and I'm Will.
And I'm Lynn.
And we're here for our 3 p.m.
Facebook
Live.
Live, right. Thank you for joining us. If you don't know who we are, thank you for listening in. We are digital networkers to help you grow your business online, learning the all-important and relevant attraction marketing skill sets. Now, why would you want to do this? Because you can learn the attraction marketing skill sets and reach a global audience in a rapid way, reach a massive audience, global, massive, pretty much the same thing, and target your exact audience. You will reach those people who are interested in what you have to offer. And the tire kickers are not the people you are going to reach. You're going to reach the people who truly are interested in what you have to offer. Attraction marketing is the way to grow. It's a proven blueprint. Several very known brand name people started with the attraction marketing technique and have parlayed themselves into pretty much a known name on social media. So if you'd like to learn this skill set that everybody started with, listen into our Facebook Live, and we'll let you know at the end of the Facebook Live.
Sure.
Where it is.
Very well said. I just add a few more things. So if you are a network marketer, a digital marketer, and you want to bring your business online, we are coaches, trainers, and mentors to do that for you. I always look at it this way. So all your traffic or all your people or all your social media, everybody that is on social media, 45% of the world's population is out there on some highway. And you want to figure out some way of attracting them to make that exit and come down your road. So they come already knowing what you have to offer. Instead of, you know, making a list of 100, chasing your family and friends, burning up your warm market, doing those one-on-one phone calls, and all that sort of stuff, chasing, you know, bartenders and servers and everybody within 3 feet, you know, with a whole lot of rejection, and what you're doing is you're repelling. So you want to learn how to attract those people, and that's what we're here to show you.
And learning it online is great. You can build your business online very effectively, very fluidly, very successfully and rapidly. Offline method is more laborious, and perhaps you're not targeting your exact audience. You aren't, because I tried it that way. It didn't work for me at all, and I gave it several years. So
yeah, when you're prospecting a stranger, you have no idea whether they're interested or not. With the attraction marketing way, they are interested before you even get to meet them, basically. So that's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool aspect of what traction marketing is. We have some great stuff. We're talking about the number one skill set in attraction marketing or digital marketing, or bringing your business online, and that is ad copy. So we're going to talk today about how to write killer ad copy, whether it be on Facebook or Instagram or anything. Also, this has a lot to do with just your regular posts. So this information that we're going to give to you today is congruent with everything that you want to do on social media, whether it be ads, posts, video content, picture content, whatever it might be. So we're going to talk about the four steps. Number one is pain. Number two is solution. Number three is benefit. And lastly, number four is call to action. So it's a really interesting little subject, and it's one of the toughest things to actually learn, the toughest skill set.
Right. Ad copy is so important and integral to your business online and attracting those people that you are interested in.
Right. So before you get started with that pain one there, just remember this.
How did you know? I'm ready to roll right into it.
Yeah, you are. Remember this. If you try to advertise to everybody, you will attract nobody. So you want to target your audience. Rock and roll, Lynn Marie.
Right. Well, if you're coming to us live.
Oh, yeah, that's right. My Lord. It's a Monday. So if you're coming to us live, please give us a little love by dropping us a heart emoji in the comment section below. If you're coming to us on a hashtag replay or on a replay, give us a hashtag replay and we'll give you a shout out later. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns during this Facebook Live, please drop them in the comments section below, or you can simply send us a message through Facebook Messenger. And as always, we love to know where everybody's coming from in this big, beautiful blue marble. So drop your location in the comments section below so we know where you're coming from. And there we go.
Perfect. So the four parts to writing killer ad copy. Number one is the pain. What is the pain that you're going through? So say you're targeting two different audiences, not in the same ad copy, but I'm using this as a as an example. Say you want to help somebody grow their business. They're not growing successfully online. They're using methods that are repelling people and they're not reaching their targeted audience. Or if you're trying to lose weight, you can talk about the pain. You know, meet the person with the pain first. What is their pain? Is it somebody who really wants to lose weight and you can offer them a solution? The pain is what you want to reach. Same with growing your business online. What is the pain that person is having? Are they not employing online methods at all? Or are they employing online methods that aren't working and are pretty much obsolete and not targeting your audience? So you want to start with that number one problem. You are not only a leader, but an expert, and you can help that person with their big pain point. So that's the first part of writing effective ad copy. You have anything to add?
Sure. So when I write ad copy, I really dig deep into what pains me. And then I basically write a bullet list of all those different pains. And that's what I focus on when I write each ad copy. Maybe last week we talked about the Blitz formula, where you're able to sit down for 90 minutes and do one thing and do it well. That's kind of how I write ad copy. I might write four ads at one shot just so I can get my head wrapped around those four different pains that I've put out there. So that's how I get off the dime, and maybe you can do that too. Is just write those pains down, then write your ad starting with that pain. Going more into what Lynn had said, maybe you're trying to talk about losing weight. So the pain for that would be maybe they're feeling unhealthy,
right?
Or maybe they have, you know, their heart. They have a problem with their heart, or their heart hurts, or maybe they're exhausted all the time. Maybe they feel sluggish. Those are pains that person that is overweight is feeling. So that's how you want to write. You want to get into those pains. Now, before I go any further with this, before we go into the next step, this is where 95% of network marketers fail, is in advertising and just getting off the dime with writing about ad copy and the pain, because that's where you should start.
Perfect. So the second part of writing killer ad copy, and let us know, drop us a one in the comments if we're offering value to you today. We'd love to know.
Give us a one.
Drop us a one. So the second component of writing killer ad copy is a solution. So you're identifying the person's pain. Their business isn't growing online successfully. They're not attracting people who are interested. They're kind of all over the place in general. The second part is solution. How can you help them? Target their exact audience, right? Help them with the solution. Instead of being general and broad and attracting everybody and no one's interested, targeting that exact audience. You're allowing and giving them, oh, look, this works. This is a viable solution. It helped me. It will help you. And we've helped so many people employ this as well, that it's helped them too, and it will help you, providing you follow the instructions on whatever you need to do. And same with weight loss. If you're providing a benefit with people to help lose weight, what are the benefits to losing weight, right?
Right.
You're providing a solution. You can help them with their blood pressure.
Right.
Or if they're borderline diabetic, their A1C is kind of in the borderline range. So anything like that where you're offering a solution, a viable solution.
Perfectly said. So you shouldn't come off with your solution immediately. So for example, we talk about the weight loss thing. So let's say you talk about, oh yeah, you feel sluggish, you don't feel well, you're overweight, you know, people, you don't look great in your swimsuit or your bikini or whatever it might be. And then you say, all you have to do is drink this milkshake. That's not how it works. So you have to show them the solution, kind of educate them on the solution, how it can change your lifestyle, how it can change their mindset, you know, how you can change your diet. So those are all solutions to the pain. They're not quite the benefit, but the solution. So let me see, what else can I say? So you want to ask, now you need to ask, what are their wants and desires moving on from that pain? That's kind of where you want to go from. That's all I got to say about that one.
Perfect.
Solution.
So again, drop us a one if this is giving value. Let us know. We want to know. So the third part of writing killer ad copy is the benefit. So if you're trying to grow your business online, what is the benefit? Well, you're not making money. Employ these tactics and strategies, and you're going to make money. If that's, of course, that's part of growing your business, right? So it's the benefit that you get if you take advantage of whatever the offer is, going from point A to the next point and actually seeing an increase and your business growing.
Sales, revenue, customers, clients.
Right.
Anything like that.
Lead sales.
Lead sales, sure. And I'm going to go back into the weight thing. So now that you've shown them the pain, you had come up with a solution, and now you're giving them the benefit. You know, the benefit, I think, Lynn, you've already kind of dug into this. Your heart feels better. You have more energy. You look better. You're more happier about yourself. Those are all things that are the benefit to that pain through the solution. So just to give you a short recap, you know, you're digging into the pain. You're educating them on what the solution is that you have found, and then you're giving the benefit. And that's it. So now we're off to call to action.
Right.
Call to action.
Yeah. Number four is the call to action. Give everybody a call to action, whether it's so many minutes to give your email and get more information, whether it's grabbing a link. Be very clear and concise as to what your call to action is. And so there's no misunderstanding by the person who's reading what you're writing, what the exact instructions and step by step. People like to be told what to do. And if you're very clear and concise about what it is, how to grab your offer, just be very clear and concise with your call to action.
Right. There's nothing else really to say. People like being told what to do. So this is probably the most important step out of these four, is giving them a call to action. You've told them about, you know, the pain. You've got them in the feeling of that pain. You've given them the solution and then what the benefit is. Now you have to tell them what to do to get through all those three steps. So call to action is probably one of the most important things.
Right, absolutely. And remember, when you're writing ad copy, be you, be unique, be you. Everybody has strengths, right? If you want to share a part of your story as well in the ad copy, just remember to be who you are, to bring it in, let your personality shine. Be engaging, don't be boring. Write it so that person wants to read the next line and then the next line and the next line, where they're interested in what you have to offer. But just remember to be you, be unique, and tell a little bit of your story, perhaps, and how it can help them, because you've been there and this is a solution that you can give them.
Stories sell because they're believing. There's a belief in a story. You know, it's kind of like the movies that everybody likes, an underdog movie or an underdog. So root for the underdog. So stories are very powerful. I would just like to leave it with just a couple of things, notes. When you do write, remember, this ad copy is not just for ad copy. It's about everything that you want to do to brand yourself, whether it be post ad copy, any content that you put out there on social media, you can use these four steps. And secondly, you can also use it on all social media platforms. All of them works the same way. Now, the last thing I want to say is that when you read your ad copy, when you go back over it, look at a few things. Number one, is it engaging? You know, does it keep the reader interested? So is it engaging, number one? Number two, is it clear? You know, is it easy to understand? So that's the second one. And number three, is it concise? You know, does it need to be here? Is it important for my story? All the little lines, because every line leads to another, as Lynn said. And last, is it persuasive? If it's not persuasive, then the other three things don't make a hill of beans. So would you click on this? Or would you want to learn more about what you just said? If you answer no to any of those, then you need to start all over again. So look at those four items. Is it engaging? Is it clear? Is it concise? And is it persuasive? And if it meets all four of those things, then boom, you got it. You can make a sale.
Right. It doesn't have to take you forever to learn how to write good ad copy. It doesn't. If you follow these four techniques, establishing the pain, the solution, the benefits, and then the call to action, and you interject your personality, you make it persuasive and engaging, and you give a very, very concise call to action, exactly what to do, you're going to be on the right road big time.
Right. So, as always, I'm going to put a link on this Facebook Live that will lead you to this blog, which will fill in a few blanks that maybe we haven't mentioned. And it's a great read. It's written by a friend of ours, Whit and Kari. And it's just a wonderful ad copy, or a lesson to learn about ad copy. And once you get into that link or read that blog, we'll be able to offer you a free 10-day attraction marketing bootcamp. And that's free, or 10 days of video content of what attraction marketing is and how it can help your business. And it's just wonderful information to get. That's how Lynn and I got started, basically.
Right. And never looked back. This is the way to go. The only place to go is grow, and attraction marketing will get you there.
Right.
And what else do you have to lose? Well, it's going to be tax day in a couple of days, July 15th, a little late this year because of COVID. But what have you done in this time? Have you created anything new? Now is the time to really shift everything and get your business rocking and rolling online, because that's where it's growing, and it's not stopping, and it's growing in a gargantuan way worldwide.
Right. That's perfect. Can't say any more of that. And then lastly, why don't you tell them about the attraction marketing formula?
Right. So this is the attraction marketing formula. Grab the link that we will attach to this Facebook Live. This is the way we got started. It's not going to cost you anything. This is a 10-day boot camp. And if you're interested, if you have a little bit of an open mind to learning how these techniques can help your business grow, you want to grab that link because this is the way to do it.
It certainly is. And hey, it's 185 pages. It's 10 chapters of great information. Again, $27. Can't beat that, right?
Can't beat it. And what happened with the lights? Is it outside? It's all different.
Yeah, we're kind of messing with the lighting in here, so things kind of changed. But anyway, anything else you got to say?
Nope, that's it.
All right. So tomorrow we're going back to our
network marketer
bookshelf. I'm not sure what the book is, but I'm sure it's a great book. We'll tell you tomorrow what the book is. And then Wednesday, I'm not sure what the subject is, but Wednesday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we'll be back on here live again.
So thank you for listening in. Please drop us a 1 if we gave you value.
Right.
Grab the link if you want to learn about attraction marketing. This is the way to grow, people.
And if you just want to talk about what attraction marketing is or get some questions, you know, answered, by all means, you know, go over to lynnandwill.com, pull down that menu where it says work with us and schedule a video call. Or, you know, send us a message through Facebook Messenger, or drop a comment in the comment section below, or you can go over to our Facebook fan page and hit the book or get the book now button and schedule a video call that way. So all kinds of ways to get a hold of us. So get a hold of us.
Well, thank you for listening in, everybody.
All right.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are.
Well, so peace,
love, and light.
Peace out, everybody.
We'll see you Wednesday at 3, and thank you for listening.
Thank you. Bye-bye.